Hey guys, Dr. Jeremy with The Active Life coming at you with a brute tip. Today we're going to be talking about double unders and some progressions that you can use other than saying, hey, go in the corner and practice. So we all have those athletes that come in, they want double unders, especially around open time. And a lot of the times you see them, you know, come a little bit early, staying a little bit late, maybe watching some videos online to get some tips. And they end up essentially just hanging out in the corner, just jumping and flailing their arms around and not necessarily getting any better. And the reason, there could be multiple reasons to that. So we want to give you some of the tools to go back and look through. So yes, you know, some people lack rhythm and that can be a problem, but we want to start to look at the components of actually, you know, having a double under and start to work through those in a systematic way to say maybe, okay, maybe you don't have the strength, maybe you don't have the bounce that you need. So the first thing that we're going to look for is strength and balance. Can this person actually stand on their toes, right, for 10 seconds at a time? Right, you need to have a certain amount of strength, a certain amount of stamina, a certain amount of balance to do that. You'll be surprised how many of your athletes will struggle with this. Once we have that, we also want to see if they have any sort of core strength or core endurance. So are they able to maintain a hollow body position? Because maintaining that position is very important to bouncing up and down, right? As we start to break through the midline, right, energy starts to shoot out in all different directions and our spine starts taking lots of load. Once we've established that they have some baseline of strength, some baseline of balance, some baseline of core strength and stamina, we like to see if they can hop. Can you simply hop up and down in place 50 times in a row without your heels touching the ground? Again, have your athletes try this. You're gonna start to see, wow, these people are gonna saying it's burning. They're saying they can't keep their heels up off the ground. They start landing really heavy later on. So these people, you know, if they're not doing it from the get-go, right? That's a little bit different than their heels starting to hit the ground maybe at the 40th or 50th rep. One's more of a stamina issue, other is just a little bit more of a strength issue. So really being able to identify if people can do that. From there, now let's get a little bit more aggressive. Now can we start to add some upper body movement on top of that and add a little bit of rhythm? So can you hop, right, and tap your hips twice while you're in the air, kind of simulating at least the rhythm of what you need to do with your hands, not necessarily the movement, but okay, I'm jumping and using my hands at the same time, okay? As you start to go through that, right, this is all without a rope, right? So I wanna see if this person can actually pretend to jump rope before I start to introduce it. Then when we introduce the rope, we wanna make sure that it's the right size, right? Making sure that it's, you know, around between nipple and armpit height. Then we can start to play with hand positions and things like that. There's a little bit more skill that's involved with a coach actually helping you out. And then from there, if somebody has all of this, they have the right rope, sometimes they're just lacking rhythm, right? So maybe they need to get a little drunk, maybe take Zumba for maybe a month or so. I'm kidding. But that's just the final piece that where they just are missing the skill. But a lot of the times when we start to regress this movement, we start to say, okay, do you have these you know, basic parts? That's where you're gonna find what that athlete's missing and you're gonna help get, and that's what they need to work on, and that's what's gonna help them get their double unders, not simply just standing in the corner and trying. So if you want to know more about this, you can go over to performancecare.com and you can check out our coaches program. We have this all laid out in our coaches module.
Is our website performancecare.com?
Nope.
Should I pull that forward to our website?
Nope. Should I just refilm that and you can lay it in?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. So you had a bit of a pause there anyway.
I did. Okay. So if you want to learn more about this, you can go over to performancecarerx.com. All of this information is in our coaches module where we take you through step by step with video demos and how to progress, regress, and what drills you need to do in order to get your athletes or yourself better at these skills.